Adding tabs and tab stops can make your life a lot easier, especially when creating things such as a table of contents. A tab stop basically is aligning somewhere on the ruler that will allow you to press the tab key and align the text up with that tab stop. Now, tab stops, there's a couple of types that you can have. You can have a left aligned tab stop, which is this L right here, and what that does is it will align the text to the left. The text will be on the right hand side aligned to the left of the text. If you click here, you can see there's a perpendicular sign. This will center align the text wherever you put this marker. That means the text, whatever the word is, will be aligned to the center of wherever this marker is. And then you have right aligned, which what this will do is it'll bump up the text right up to that point wherever you put it on the ruler. You also have a decimal alignment, which will allow you to align numbers based on the decimal. We're going to click back through and go to the first one, left align, the black L. To add in a tab stop, simply click up on the ruler where you want your tab stop to be. If your ruler is not shown, click on View and then check Ruler. So now what we're going to do is click, let's go ahead and add a tab stop on, I'm going to highlight this paragraph, and we're going to create a tab stop at 4 inches. I simply click on the ruler, this L appears. If I want to move it, if I didn't get it right where I wanted, I can click on the L, drag it to the right or drag it to the left, and you can see that dashed line shows me where this tab stop is going to be. So I go ahead, I'm going to leave it at 4 inches. Click my cursor in between chapter 1 and page 1. I press the tab key, and this aligns the text right up with that point. If I change the type of tab stop I have, for example, in this paragraph, I'm going to change this tab stop. Instead of a left align, I'm going to change it to a right align. To do that, I double click on the tab stop. It brings up the tab options. It's showing me I'm at the 4-inch tab position. It's a left align. I'm going to change it to a right align. Select OK. Now when I press the tab key, it's now aligned up to the right on this tab stop. So the text is aligned pushing to the right, or it's on the left hand side. I'm going to do this once more. I'm going to click in between chapter 3 and page 26, double click on my tab stop. If you click below, it won't do it. I double click on the tab stop. It brings up this option. I'm going to change it to a center align. I click OK. Now I press the tab key, and you can see this one is aligned to the center of that. This one is aligned on the left-hand side, but it's pushed up to the right. So this is called a right align, and this one is a left align. You can remember because of the black L, and it's butted right up next to it right there. To get rid of the tab stops, make sure you're selected in the paragraph or in the line that the tab stop is in. Click and just drag the tab stop off, and it will disappear and remove your tab stop. So I'm going to remove each of my tab stops. What I want to do is add in a tab stop with a dot leader. To add in the tab stop, I can click up here and click on the ruler, or from my home tab, I can go to the paragraph panel, and I'm going to click on the twirl out menu, which gives me paragraph options. You can see that here. I'm going to click down on the tabs button. The tabs button now shows me all of the options I have for the tab. And I want to make this tab at exactly 5 inches. So I'm going to type that in there. And I want to add a dot leader, which means there's going to be a lot of dots or periods in between the chapter and the page that it's found on. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And you can see this dot leader is applied. If I delete that, I press the tab key, it will automatically push my text all the way to this tab stop and put in the periods. It doesn't matter if I change the amount of text I have, it will automatically update how many dots are in the dot leader. So this is something really nice in Microsoft Word, is adding a dot leader using tabs to your documents. Now if I want this dot leader on each one to be the same, I simply select them, click up on the twirl out menu for paragraph, click down on tabs, and I make them all at 5 inches with a dot leader. I click OK. Now these ones didn't work because I have not pressed tab yet. I press tab. Oh, looks like there's one already created there. Let me delete that. Press tab, and there's one there, so let me delete that. And press tab, and there you have it. You have a fancy looking table of contents.